Well, folks, you probably can't really see me because of the light. I'm out in the street, actually. But this is Chris Lott, from Think Legacy Channel. Basically, I just want to do a video just telling you, talking about the Lord, basically, and telling you how good he's been to me in my life, even though I've had such a miserable and horrible life most of my life. The trials and tribulations I've been through have been very hard and pretty stressful, you know, because I'll just give you the gist of a first, right? Basically, bad childhood, you know, in and out of the care system, then 11 years of age, then into the care system on the streets, homeless, up until and in and out of prison and drugs and crime and all of that goes with that lifestyle. Been there, done that, wore the t-shirt. But I'm climbing out of that dark abyss now, and it's all thanks to the Lord. Like, I have my own home, I'm clean, I have kids now, but that's the gist of it. But I'm going to be doing a blog basically every night, and each night, as each night comes by, I'm going to have a different story basically to tell you, just about saving people. What story, Robbie? All right, Paul? All right, what story? Just about... Right. What story, Paul? Well, just... I'll be giving you a new blog every night about... basically... say, right, for example, prison. The trials and tribulations I went through as a child. The abuse I went through as a child. Living on the streets. Crime, breaking the law, taking heroin, smoking crack, whatever the case, you know. My father's passing, the lives that I've saved, whatever it may be, it'll be positive, put it that way. I'm just walking down the street, actually, just doing this blog, so here's to it. So this is the first video, basically first blog that I'm doing on letting you know what I'm doing. And I'll start off with when I was a child, basically, right? It's not going to be long, but when I was 11 years of age, I was made homeless. Now there's stuff before that, right? But when I was 11, I was made homeless. I was found on the Geo Carriageway. That's like a main road, a big long road, you know. Highway, or if anyone, the highway in America, do you call it that? But I was found on that at 2:30 in the morning by the guardie, by the police, and the lessons around. And that's where it really begun for me. To this point, from that point to this point, that's the start. But basically, found on the streets, like I said, taken into the care system. I was put in, the first home I was put in was, I was the youngest. I was only a baby, I was only a child. I was 11 years of age. And basically the carers that were there for me, that were there looking after me, they were actually taking drugs. One that was an alcoholic, he used to bring in bags of cans, yeah. And a lump of hash, and he'd sit down and smoke his blow, get me to make joints, get cans for me. I'd be sitting there drinking them. There was heroin addicts in the house. I was exposed to so much I was exposed to. Now, at the time, I didn't know the Lord. I knew him, but I didn't have a relationship with him. And I didn't know that he was there protecting me and looking after me. It was only as I got older and reevaluated my life, basically, and when I was starting writing a book, when I was starting writing that, then I was analysing my whole life and come to a realisation that the Lord has been there holding my hand all the way. And I realised at so many points of where he was, I've realised at so many points that he was there. When I look back, I think, oh wow, the Lord Heavenly Father, he was actually standing there with me. He was actually, it was him that got me out of that situation. It was him that pulled me away. It was him that shielded me from an attack, or it was him that saved my life when I OD, or whatever the case. getting stabbed or whatever, he was there, he's saved me, and that's what he's about, you know. And for anybody that's watching this and looking at it, like, to all you people out there that think, oh, holy God, Bible bastards and this, that, and the other, that's just a lack of knowledge. What's the holy good day? All right, Paul? Hey. Go on. But people that think that the Lord, it's all about Bible bashing and all that carry on, to be honest, that's just a lack of knowledge. I'm not going to judge you because that's not my job. But what I can do is I can actually spread the word of the Lord and actually tell you what he's done for me in my life, how good he's been to me in my life. And maybe you will come to some realisation that the same can also be done for you. All right, Paul. The same can also be done for you, and it can be done for anybody. It can be done for, like, Tom, Dick and Hardy. Every single person basically on this planet can have the same as me. They can have more, and I'm still on my journey, and I'm seeking more, because the Lord is everlasting and eternal, and that is the way of it. Sorry about this, I know it's pretty dark, all right?
I'm sorry,
Dave. Oh, but sorry, Bull, are you well? All right, Paul, how's it going? I know I'm in the dark now, so sorry about that, folks. Here's a bit of light. But basically, if you can pick up what I'm saying, about, like, how God has helped me in my life and how he's so merciful and forgiving, because he is. He's amazing. Lord Heavenly Father, he's so amazing, like, and he's really worth it. Because we're worth it to him, we're his children. Like, and there's no two ways about it, you know, like, he's given us this life, he's created us, Jamie. Like, we owe it to ourselves to take it on board that he's there and accept him into our hearts as our personal Lord and Saviour, repent for our sins, and then have a relationship with him, and then, you know, and it goes from there. Now, like I said, this is just the first blog about the story of me and how he's helped me. But what I've done here is just to try and give you a bit of an understanding. Just a gist of me, but an understanding, like, of that he's been there all the way. Through the thick and the thin, through the fat and the slim, through whatever. He's been there. Yeah? So I want you to know that he's there for you too. Not just me. Not just Joseph next door or down the road. He's there for everybody, do you get me? So on that point, turn your heart towards his, turn your face towards him, and just accept him into your heart as your personal Lord and Savior. And I promise you that he will be there with you, and there's no two ways about it. So I'm just going to leave it at that, because I'm coming back up to the house, coming back up to the apartment. I want you to know that Jesus loves you. I love you all. We're all brothers and sisters in the eyes of God. We're all his children, and that he works wonders, and he will help you as long as you put some work in and you call him into your heart. He'll help you. So on the next blog, I'll probably do another one now tonight for you. But basically, on the next one, I'm going to start off from when I was a child, at the age of 11, right? Like I said at the start, I'll take it from there. Now, there's just a Rob motorbike flying up down the place. I'm sure you can hear that. But anyway, I'm going to take it to the... Like I said, sorry, I got distracted there. I'll take it back to when I was 11. And I'll start it from there. I'll give you an insight into my life, and I'll tell you a lot about me and what the Lord has done for me. There he is there, and his mother, the Blessed Mary. The two of them. But listen, God bless and be safe. In Yeshua HaMessiah's name I pray. Bye-bye. Amen.